Greetings, everyone, and welcome. I'm the Chancellor of Soul, Mike Boone. You tune in to another edition of Soul Facts, a show highlighting the history and music of legendary artists and preserving their legacies. In this edition of Soul Facts features an artist whose rich, booming baritone voice achieved major success in both the R&B and pop field by combining semi-classic techniques with a traditional black gospel feel that brought soul to the Great American Songbook from the 1950s throughout the late 1960s. Soul Facts spotlight artist, the one and only Mr. Roy Hamilton. Born Tuesday, April 16, 1929, in Leesburg, Georgia, Rethotis Hamilton, affectionately called Roy, began his musical journey singing in his local church choir at the tender age of six. In the summer of 1943, Roy was just 14, his family migrated north to Jersey City, New Jersey, in search of a better life. He became a featured soloist at the Central Baptist Church Choir. At Lincoln High School, where he attended, Hamilton soon turned his path towards performing arts, where he studied commercial painting and was so gifted enough to display his paintings with a number of New York galleries. In February 1947, 17-year-old Roy Hamilton switched from gospel to secular music. Some document sources say that Roy Hamilton won a talent contest at the Apollo Theater, singing a specialty song, You'll Never Walk Alone. But nothing came out of it. Hamilton said that he couldn't get an even break and that he had nothing to offer. At the time, they were seeking blues singers, and I didn't know any blues at all. Now, here's another story. In Ted Fox's classic 1983 book, Showtime at the Apollo, republished in 2003, wrote that Roy Hamilton appeared at Apollo Theater's Amateur Night on Wednesdays and sang You'll Never Walk Alone and fell flat during the last few bars of the song, getting a reaction from the audience and repeated tirades from stagehand Puerto Rico. Plus, each time Hamilton fell flat in voice, the microphone in the center of the stage would sink downward. This, of course, never shook Roy's confidence. He won a poor third on the show. Now, witnessing this event was an up-and-coming young comedian named Flip Wilson. To support himself while trying to develop the singing style he wanted, Hamilton worked as an electronics technician during the day and as an amateur heavyweight boxer at night, where he won six victories and one defeat. Now, realizing the danger and violence the sport represented, he soon quit boxing. In 1948, Roy Hamilton joined the Searchlight Gospel Singers while studying light opera with the New Jersey vocal coach J. Martin Dawes for more than a year's time. Roy continued to perform with the Searchlight Singers in various churches and gospel events. In 1953, the gospel group broke up, with each member going in their own direction. With more preparation, Roy Hamilton headed back to secular music with a more confident approach and a distinctive style of singing. In mid-1953, Roy continued to perform in clubs throughout New Jersey and New York. He was discovered singing in the Newark, New Jersey nightclub called The Caravan by Bill Cook, a DJ who hosted a live radio program at the club. He quickly became Roy's manager. Cook was one of the first African-American radio jocks and television personality and songwriters on the West Coast. He was also known for composing Sam Cooke's hit of November 1957, I'll Come Running Back to You, released on Specialty Records. Bill Cook made a demo tape of Hamilton singing and brought it to the attention of Columbia Records. Columbia was impressed enough to sign him to a deal and assign him to the R&B sub-label OK Records. Roy Hamilton's first recording session took place on Wednesday, November 11, 1953, with a Rodgers and Hammerstein tune called You'll Never Walk Alone from the musical Carousel, a number Hamilton performed live since 1947. Before its release, Columbia decided to place Roy with their newly launched pop sub-imprint label, Epic. Seeing potential in Hamilton as a crossover artist, the company placed a full-page ad in the January 23, 1954 edition of Billboard magazine, which read, "A great new voice makes news with a great song. Roy Hamilton's You'll Never Walk Alone." Hamilton's performance on Walk Alone is stupendous. Back with I'm Gonna Sit Right Down and Cry Over You.
I'm gonna sit right down and cry over you. Whoa.
You'll Never Walk Alone charted number one R&B for 8 weeks on March 17, 1954, and number 21 pop. Hamilton's B-side, I'm Gonna Sit Right Down and Cry Over You, was later recorded by Elvis Presley, featured on his self-titled debut album on RCA Records in 1956. His follow-up single, If I Loved You, another Rodgers and Hammerstein tune from Carousel, back with So Let There Be Love, hit number four R&B June 16th of 1954.
Yeah, I love you, so let there be love.
On Saturday evening, July 24th, 1954, Roy Hamilton appeared on the bill of Star Night, a concert package at Chicago's Soldier Field, starring Perry Como, Nat King Cole, and Sarah Vaughan. Now, since he was a newcomer on the bill, Hamilton was only given 6 minutes to perform two songs. Roy planned to perform You'll Never Walk Alone, along with his B-side, I'm Gonna Sit Right Down and Cry Over You. But Perry Como squashed that plan when he announced during the afternoon rehearsals that Walk Alone was going to be his closing number that evening. After a last-minute forced decision, Roy decided on Ebb Tide, a song that was a hit for singer Vic Damone a few months earlier, a song that Hamilton himself had yet recorded. That evening, for his second and finale number, Roy unveiled his gospel tingle version of Ebb Tide before an audience of 82,000, where they gave him a standing ovation, stomping and chanting for more. Hamilton had to be summoned back out on the stage to tame the crowd. He witnessed some of his fellow performers, Nat Cole, Sarah Vaughan, and orchestra leader Ray Anthony, had joined in the ovation. On July 28th, 4 days after his Star Night triumph, Epic Records had Hamilton record Ebb Tide. Back with Beware, Ebb Tide became Roy's third straight hit, charting number five R&B September 29th of 1954.
First the tide rushes in, plants a kiss on the shore.
Roy Hamilton's fourth top 10 hit was Hurt, back with Star of Love, reaching number 8 R&B in January of 1955. Singer Timmy Yarrell covered a version of Hurt that hit number 4 pop on September 17, 1961, along with other cover versions by artists like the Manhattans, who hit number 10 R&B during the late spring summer of 1975, and Elvis Presley and Juice Newton, among the many. But Roy Hamilton was the originator. On Saturday night, September 11, 1954, Roy Hamilton made his national television debut on CBS's stage show, hosted by big band leaders and brothers Tommy and Jimmy Dorsey. But the national television appearance that put Hamilton's career on the map to crossover success was the one he made on CBS's top-rated program, The Ed Sullivan Show. 10 days after the Sullivan appearance, Epic Records, in a rushed attempt to cover singer Al Hibbler's version of Unchained Melody, set up a recording session for Hamilton. The single was recorded and shipped within 5 days. Back with From Here to Eternity, Unchained Melody zoomed to the number one position on the R&B charts on May 21st, 1955, 3 weeks, while on the pop charts, it had reached the number six spot. It was Roy's second number one R&B hit of his career.
Oh, my love, my darling, I hungered for your touch. You vowed your love from here to eternity.
Unchained Melody is a 1955 song composed by Alex North and Hy Zarrett. The song was written as a theme for the prison film Unchained, released in theaters in January 1955 and sung originally in the movie by baritone opera singer and actor Todd Duncan. 10 years later, The Righteous Brothers, with solo lead vocals by Bobby Hatfield, made it a massive hit twice, first charting number four pop on August 26, 1965, and also reappearing on the charts 25 years later, reaching number 27 after it gained popularity when featured in the 1990 box office blockbuster film Ghost. 1,500 recordings of Unchained Melody have been made by more than 670 artists in multiple languages. Roy Hamilton was named Vocalist of the Year in the May 18, 1955 issue of Downbeat Magazine. On the heels of his Unchained Melody success, Roy Hamilton recorded the following Great American Songbook singles in succession. Vincent Youthman's Without a Song from the 1929 musical Great Day, along with his B-side, Jimmy McHugh's Cuban Love Song in 1955. Rodgers and Hammerstein's Everybody's Got a Home With Me from the 1955 musical Pipe Dreams, back with Take Me With You in 1955.
Everybody's got a home but me. Take me with you. Take me with you.
And Frank Lesser, Somebody's Somewhere, from the 1956 musical The Most Happy Fella, back with the 1945 blues ballad composed by pianist and bandleader Buddy Johnson and popularized by his sister Ella Johnson, Since I Fell for You in 1956. Also a huge hit for Lenny Welch in 1963.
Somebody somewhere wants me and needs me. I guess I'll never be the same since I fell for you.
Roy Hamilton's last top 10 R&B hit of 1955 was Forgive This Fool, back with You Wanted to Change Me, number 10 R&B in August of 1955.
Forgive this fool. I never loved before, but you wanted to change me and change all my ways.
Roy Roy Hamilton played to mixed crowds, predominantly white female audiences, when he stunned them with his operatic vocals, nearly causing riots, like the one in Revere, Massachusetts, reported by Cash Magazine, where they went berserk and stormed the stage, which was considered a no-no in various segregated states across the U.S. After Ed Sullivan, Hamilton made television guest appearances on various shows, such as Jackie Gleason, Steve Allen, American Bandstand, and years later, Mike Douglas. In mid-1956, Roy was forced into a premature retirement by a case of tubercular pneumonia, a lung condition the doctors told him would prevent him from ever singing again. After a brief hiatus in 1957, Roy Hamilton resumed his career, but could no longer generate hit singles performing pop standards because overnight, rock and roll had become the record industry's predominant commercial force. So on Monday, December 2nd, 1957, Epi coaxed Hamilton in recording Don't Let Go, an R&B rocker composed by musician and songwriter Jesse Stone, known for his R&B pop anthem Shake, Rattle, and Roll, recorded by Big Joe Turner on Atlantic Records in 1954. Back with The Night to Love, Don't Let Go hit number 2 on February 22nd, 1958. The song had become the second U.S. top R&B pop hit of Hamilton's career and one of the first top 40 hits ever recorded in stereo.
Hear that whistle, it's 10 o'clock.
Don't let go, don't let go.
Come on, baby, it's time to rock.
Don't let go, don't let go.
21 years later, singer-songwriter Isaac Hayes recorded a disco version of Don't Let Go, where it charted number 11 R&B in September of 1979. Roy Hamilton appeared in two pictures, Let's Rock in 1958, where he performs Here Comes Love, and Hawaiian Boy in 1959, where he sings Unchained Melody. During this time, Jerry Butler and the Impressions release For Your Precious Love on VJ Records in May 1958. Now the company got wind that Roy Hamilton was going to cover the song and release it. Hamilton was a hot commodity in the industry, while the Impressions were an unknown group at the time. So Ewart Abner, part owner and general manager of VJ Records, planned a promotional tour for the Impressions for national exposure and featured ads from various trade papers to stop this false stall of Hamilton covering the song. Roy eventually covered the song a few years later. Epic issued Roy Hamilton's 25th single in April of 1959, I Need Your Lovin', back with Blue Prelude, number 14 on Billboard's Hot R&B Sides on May 4th of 1959.
Little girl, you know I need your love.
The Epic label now became known as the house that Roy Hamilton built, as the company treated him as a major star and issued 16 albums by him. Hamilton joined the Henry Winn's Package Tour in June of 1961 that included Little Willie John and Sam Cooke, who was inspired to switch from gospel to secular music by Hamilton during the early portion of his career. Roy Hamilton's last hit record on the R&B pop charts was You Can Have Her, back with Abide With Me, charting number 6 R&B on February 20th of 1961. Here, you can hear the heavy influence of Roy Hamilton that was later copied by Elvis Presley.
Well, you can have her. I don't want her. She didn't love me anyway.
Despite the success in 1962, Epic Records decided not to renew Roy Hamilton's contract with the company. Hamilton's last single for the label was The Uncharted Earthquake, back with I Am, released on Friday, September 17th of 1962.
I am in the eyes of the world.
In early 1963, Roy Hamilton inked a deal with MGM Records. The label released 7 Uncharted singles on Hamilton, including his first for the imprint, Let Go, back with You Still Love Him, both tunes co-composed by singer-songwriter Van McCoy under the production of songwriting team Jerry Lieber and Mike Stoller.
Let go, he's not in love with you.
And the theme from The VIP's The Willow, a 1963 movie starring Elizabeth Taylor and Richard Burton, back with The Sinner, El Pecador.
I walk on mushy sunny, it's a monocle. When you've broken the rule, you're a sinner.
Two MGM albums were also issued on Roy Hamilton, Warm Soul in 1963 and Sentimental, Lonely and Blue in 1964. Around this time, the March on Washington took place on Wednesday, August 28, 1963 in Washington, D.C., where Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. gave his infamous great 20th century speech, I Have a Dream. Roy Hamilton attended the march. He was so inspired by the event, he wrote a letter to CORE, Congress of Racial Equality National Director James Farmer, and said to him, I still feel that there is something I personally can contribute to. Don't hesitate to call on me. But he didn't hear from the organization for 5 months. They wanted high-profile artists like Sammy Davis Jr., Harry Belafonte, Nat King Cole, who appealed to whites and black middle class, to more or less draw an attraction to the civil rights cause and their organization. Roy Hamilton was so disappointed. After a year with MGM Records, Roy signed with RCA and issued 7 Uncharted singles, including Cracking Up Over You, back with Walk Hand in Hand, and his last recorded album, The Impossible Dream, in 1966. Without proper promotion and support from the company, Roy Hamilton left and switched over to Capitol Records in 1967, releasing one single, Let This World Be Free, back with Wait Until Dark, in December of 1967. By this time, Roy Hamilton's career had declined. In January 1969, he trekked down to Chips Moorman's American Sound Studios in Memphis, Tennessee to make the final recordings of his career. The tracks were laid down and produced by Chips Moorman and Tommy Cogbill. At the same time, Elvis Presley was recording his infamous album, Elvis in Memphis. Presley greatly admired Roy Hamilton's singing ability and performed numerous of songs in Roy's style. In July 1969, Elvis finally met his singing hero by attending Hamilton's early recording sessions. Presley's sessions were at night, so he arrived early to listen to Roy. It was during their meeting that Elvis offered Roy the song that was submitted to him to record, called Angelica, a tune composed by Barry Mann and Cynthia Wayle. Two other songs were recorded and released on Hamilton, including James Carr's The Dark End of the Street and Conway Twitty's It's Only Make Believe.
At the dark end of the street, but it's only, only me, only make believe.
Angelica, a beautiful operatic soaring dramatic song, failed to gain any support from the label or airplay, like the other two. Angelica turned out to be Roy's last single.
Angelica, sweet Angelica.
Sadly, Roy Hamilton suffered a massive cerebral hemorrhage at his home in New Rochelle, New York. He was taken to New Rochelle General Hospital, where he laid in a coma for more than a week. On Sunday, July 20th, 1969, Roy was removed from life support and passed away. He was 40 years old. He left behind his wife Myrna and two sons, Roy Hamilton Jr. and Ray Hamilton. At the time of death, Roy was heavily in financial debt, forcing him to borrow heavily on his insurance policy to pay off back taxes. This unfortunately prompted his widow Myrna to publicly seek funds for his burial. Hamilton is buried in the Pine Lands section of Ferncliff Cemetery, yards away from civil rights activist and Muslim minister Malcolm X in Westchester County in New York. 1,200 attended his funeral. Messages of condolences were sent by Elvis Presley, gospel singer Mahalia Jackson, and blues legend B.B. King. Besides Elvis Presley, Roy Hamilton influenced countless of artists, including Sam Cooke, who submitted his early compositions to Roy, Jackie Wilson, and the Righteous Brothers, who emulated Hamilton's style that erected their blue-eyed soul sound through their cover versions of his songs. Unchained Melody, Ebb Tide, and You'll Never Walk Alone. Singer Darlene Love said that her mother would sing to Roy Hamilton's music while house cleaning, and that she was one heck of a singer. In January 2009, Roy Hamilton was inducted into the Hit Parade Hall of Fame, Reflections in Black Museum Hall of Fame, and the Georgia Music Hall of Fame. Roy has been also granted an honorary laureate degree at Morris Brown University in Atlanta, Georgia. Hamilton's memory is left alive by the endless volumes of work he left in his stead, including his family, who tirelessly worked to ensure that his legacy will never be forgotten. Hamilton's son, Roy Hamilton Jr., and grandson, Roy Hamilton III, continue to carry the flaming torch of his legacy through their continuous work in the industry. The golden voice of Roy Hamilton left a lasting imprint in the industry, staking his engraved footprint on a solid music foundation that will be forever honored and celebrated with great prestige. Let's just be thankful that the music outlives the man. Until we meet again, fans out there in Soul Land, I am the Chancellor of Soul.
Hear that whistle, it's 10 o'clock.
Don't let go, don't let go.
Soul Facts, a show written, created, produced, and copywritten by the Chancellor of Soul, Mike Boone. Soul Facts is a nonprofit music presentation.